In areas where there isn't fiber, it's kind of tough to get real high speed, nice, dense 5G rollout because there might not be the fiber backhaul to back that up.
Yeah, so you gotta at least get it to
the tower. Yeah, exactly.
Right?
Yeah, you need multi gigabit to the tower or it can't be that fast. And so Google has this Taara project. It's like one of their moonshot projects and really to kind of revolutionize backhaul. So get 20 gigabits between towers.
Laser.
With a laser, yes.
A self aligning laser.
Yep. So microwave backhaul and laser backhaul is not really a new thing, but this seems like a really fresh kind of modern take on it and yeah. Really solves a lot of like the
20 gigabits is a lot of speed.
It is a lot of speed, yeah. They say about 20 kilometers. I'm not sure how much of that is just assuming you can get it high enough off the ground that you know, you can actually get 20 kilometers before you hit the earth. Yeah. It's probably a lot to do.
It aligns its own lenses. And they say it can even change frequencies to get through different weather. So they're talking about 99.99 uptime, meaning an hour a year you can expect it to not work. It almost seems too good.
It does, but I mean you could pack a lot of smarts in there. They're working with T-Mobile right now to roll that out.
T-Mobile announced they were going to use it for special events. Some of these concerts in the desert, they can put up a tower and use a laser to get it to somewhere else. So Liberty was talking about using it in the Caribbean. There are a number of islands where you can see the next island. So they're just talking about putting a laser and having 20 gigabits between islands without running fiber till hurricane season rolls around. But
and that's sort of the issue with the old school like microwave backhaul and old laser backhaul is if the self-homing, you know, the self-lining stuff really works out, storm passes, everything's fine again. You know, you don't need to wait a week for the engineer to come on site and reorient everything. Yeah, get everything lined up again before you get back to full speed.
I assume it uses a lot of power, right?
It doesn't. They say it uses 40 watts, which
40
is...
40 watts?
Yeah.
That's less than a MacBook Pro, right?
It is less than a MacBook Pro, yeah. A couple batteries and a solar panel, and you can have one of these things running all the time. A whole lot more people are going to get consistent 200 megabit 5G, no matter where they are.
We have a lot more tech discussions on our channel, so check out the linked video.